Hi there, welcome. Let's see quickly how to build and manage 2D projects with AutoCAD 2015. Leave feedbacks to correct any mistakes you find in this video. When you work in 2D, you have different kinds of objects you can draw. The circles, ellipses, and arcs are drawn once per time. You have to press Enter key to enable these tools again to draw another object. The line is a straight segment, but unless you press Escape key, you will go on drawing segments sharing one same node. You may build a polygon in this way, but if you analyze it, the different segments stay independent. Very differently goes when using the polyline. This works just like the line, but if you create a polygon using a polyline, all the segments are managed at the same time. This is indeed a unique object, rather than before with the line tool. Moreover, you can't convert a straight segment into an arc directly. And to modify your polygon made with the line tool, you need to use the modify section on top, since you have to edit more objects at the same time. The polyline doesn't have this problem. The object is unique, so any editing is applied on the whole polyline. You will still need the move tool to move the polyline around. Plus, you can hover the intermediate nodes and use Convert to Arc to transform a side into an arc pretty fast. Actually, the rectangle and the polygon tools do create a polyline, with a shape of a rectangle or the desired polygon. In fact, you can still find the intermediate blue nodes there too. You can edit a polyline keeping some sides fixed. Hold Shift down and click on the nodes you don't want to move between each other. Then just stretch one of these. A polyline can be decomposed. For example, you can extract the single segments from a polygon made. Select the whole object and press the letter E and choose Explode command. You can find it in Modify section too. In this way, the polyline will be transformed into its smaller parts, such as single independent segments and arcs. Let's see now some common tools used in 2D projects. The offset tool is used every time you need to create a line that goes parallel with another one. For example, let's create the letter D. Select the object and click on Offset in Modify section. Set the distance and then, in the end, accept with Enter key. A new object will be created with the same shape, but such that the distance between this and the previous object is kept constant. Another great tools are the fillet and the chamfer ones. These are used to connect segments separated. Just select the two segments and watch the preview. What if you want to fill up this letter D? You can add filled areas using the Edge tool. This is located right below the Ellipse tool. A new window called Edge Creation appears, containing all you need to fill enclosed areas. The Edge tool is very simple. All you need to do is to click inside the area you want to fill up. If you have a mistake, Remember to use the undo button in the top left corner. Of course, this is going to work if AutoCAD finds closed boundaries. Otherwise, a warning appears in a dialog box and nothing will be done. When you finish with the Edge tool, just press Enter key. The Edge creation window will be closed. The Edge tool adds patterns inside any closed boundary, composed by any kind of objects. What counts mostly is the first boundary met. So if you need to cover what is over a certain boundary, you have to click on and on where needed. These patterns are objects themselves, indeed, that you can move through their central point and edit freely using the other blue nodes. Remember that each time you use the Edge tool, a single unified pattern object is created, and this is moved and edited altogether. To create single patterns, all independent, you may need to activate the Edge tool for each single pattern. So you need to activate the Edge tool, create the pattern, and then press Enter to exit. Then press Enter again to reactivate the Edge tool for the next pattern, and so on. Mind that if you move the pattern, it will be pretty hard to replace it on the object it was covering. The Move tool deassociates the pattern from the object permanently, which means that the pattern and the boundaries do become independent. If you want to make the pattern associated again, just remove the old one and use the Edge tool on the boundaries again. As long as the pattern is associated to a boundary, this will be adapted every time the boundary changes. This happens if the pattern is kept associative. In case you lost the boundaries, but you still have the pattern, simply select it and go to Recreate in Boundaries section on top. Select Polyline and press Enter twice. AutoCAD will replace a polyline that fully covers the whole pattern selected. To delete the pattern, just select it and press Delete or Ctrl and X as with a normal object. The pattern is fully customizable. Just select it and the Edge creation window will appear. Use Pattern to change the way the object has to appear. As you can see, there are patterns from the roof, the walls, anything to design a house. In Properties section, you can fully edit it. You can add transparency, change the orientation, the pattern scale, color, and its background. Make sure to put things the easiest way possible. If you choose a very small scale, your computer may be slowed down. You have three main kinds of covers: the plain solid color, the pattern, but also the gradients. Choose the colors and the kind of gradient on the left. All gradients are recognized through the GR letters in front of names. To further edit your pattern or gradient, you can click on the small white arrow next to Options. What about text and annotations? These are all listed in the Annotation section. You can create text clicking on the A button. Then click and drag to create the text area that will contain text. The down arrow indicates where the text spreads when you make new lines. Once done, set the text style before typing in. On top you have the text editor that contains all you need to rule text. In style, choose the text style. Type 50 or 100 to see text properly. And press Enter key to apply. Below, through mask, you can add a background color placed right below the written text. In formatting, choose the font, the color, make text italic, bold or underlined. You can try paragraph and insert on your own. When you finish, press Escape key and click on Yes in the dialog box. When the text is done, you can manage it easily. The blue squared node is used to move the text. The blue arrows to identify and modify the text area. Mind that if the text area is too small, you may change the text distribution itself. If you want to edit text, just select it, right-click and go to M Text Edit, or simply double-click on it. This opens the text editor again, and so you can change the text as seen. Text is managed as any other object, using the Modify section on top. If you want to write text that has an inclination, you can do it fast without using the Rotate tool every time. Below the A button, select a single line. Click once to set where the text has to start. Type the text size inside the command box. And then set the angle of inclination respect to X axis, the horizontal direction. You can do this typing this angle or simply fixing the direction using the dashed segment that your mouse creates with the starting point. Then type the text inside. There is no text area, so you can type there or elsewhere. Just click outside. When you are done, just click outside and press Escape key. The text will have the fixed inclination decided. This text doesn't have any text area, so you will have just a blue node to move it around. Thanks for watching this video. Check out the following one to see how to design 3D projects with AutoCAD 2015.